In this movie, you will learn about placing and modifying 3D cutouts. You can place cutouts such as furniture and cars as 3D entities into your scene, which means that you can place the cutout at any angle and select the most appropriate view of the cutout to best suit your scene. 3D cutouts are placed in the scene in exactly the same way as 2D cutouts. First of all, select the cutout tool from the tools toolbar, and then click the Browse button to locate a 3D cutout file. 3D cutouts are model files, and you can choose from any of these 3D file types: RPC object, DXF files, MicroGDS man files, 3DS format files, and SketchUp files. Let's select this 3DS file of a seat. Piranesi has automatically calculated the correct size of the cutout from the model file. And let's place this seat in the scene. And clicking the Advanced Settings button displays the cutout settings palette. In the material list here, you have three choices. Selecting Single New would create a single new material name for each new model used. Multiple New would create one new material name for each material in each new model. And in this case, we will select the option Multiple Shared, which preserves the original model material names exactly so that they are shared by multiple models. Let me drag the information bar over here so you can see that the seat is made up from three materials: fabric, cushion, and wood. Now let's click the Browse button and select this 3D cutout of a large pot. And we'll place it here. The facet edges of the pot are clearly visible here. Whilst the cutout is floating in the scene, I can smooth the edges by selecting the Smooth option on the Cutout Settings palette, and then reapplying the cutout. And when the Use Colors box is ticked, and Piranesi will use the same colors as are used by the model. If this option is not checked, as it is now, then the model takes the current color as set in the toolbox. I can also change the color of a floating cutout, and let's do it. Reddish terracotta, I think. And again, reapply to see the effect. Now, let's look at some of the options with tweaking 3D cutouts. I'm going to display the Cutout Manager and tidy up my screen by dragging the Cutout Manager and dropping it over the top of the Cutout Settings palette. The palettes are now combined into a separate tabbed window. And now I'm going to click the Tweak button here. As with 2D cutouts, when my cursor shows a red arrow, I can move the cutout. Now, when I grab this middle handle on the tweak frame and drag it to about here, the pot width has been stretched, and you can see that here in the settings palette. And press undo to reinstate the pot back to its original size and position. Piranesi undoes an entire tweak sequence. When I press the Alt key at the same time, the pot stretches about its hook point, like this. And we'll undo again. When I grab and drag any one of these corner handles, the width and height are adjusted, as you can see here. And pressing the Shift key will maintain the aspect ratio of the pot. Press the Alt key at the same time to preserve the hook point position. An alternative method of selecting and tweaking a cutout other than via the Cutout Manager is to press the Ctrl and W on the keyboard when my mouse pointer is over the seat, like this. I can rotate the cutout about the Z or blue axis by grabbing this axis, which is showing a blue cursor. And now let's align the seat with the wall here. In order to rotate the chair so that this green axis is perpendicular to the wall, I click on the axis with the Shift key pressed, slide my mouse over to the wall, and release my mouse button, and then the Shift key, and the cutout refreshes. To abut the back of the seat to the wall, I can press the Shift key down and select this center handle on the tweak frame, drag to the wall, and release like so. Let's select the pot again and click the Tweak button. Now, normally, if I grab the handle on the tweak frame, the cutout will stretch. But this time, I'm going to press the Control key down whilst dragging the center handle. And as you can see, the pot has clipped from the top. Drag this handle with the control key pressed, and it clips from the right. To finish this tutorial, let's look at 3D text and a couple of features with RPC Smart content files. I'm going to open an external view. 3D text is placed in the scene in exactly the same way as 2D text. Let's place the word hotel up here on this fascia. I need to select the text tool and then type my text here. The text is in tangent mode, which means I can place it on the face of the fascia, and I'll press the font button and we'll keep the font as Arial. Let's put in 3 meters for the width. And we'll place our sign here. Now this looks a little bit flat. So let's add a thickness of 200 millimeters and offset the text by 300 millimeters from the fascia. And now we will see the changes when I press the reapply button. So now we have 3D text which is offset from the building and also cast shadows. Let's look at placing RPC Smart content files in the scene. They are also placed with the Cutout tool, and we will browse for an RPC file. Let's select this BMW car. Before I place the car in the scene, I must remove from the Cutout Settings tab the offset of 300 millimeters I'd set with the 3D text, or the car will appear to hover over the road. And let's place the car here. I can tweak the car in exactly the same way as any cutout, and rotate the car around. And when I double-click over the car in the Cutout Manager, the Cutout Settings palette is populated with the Tweak Cutout Details. And I'm offered the RPC Details button. In this dialog, I can, for example, adjust the steering. And finally, I could tint the windows and add a registration plate. And let's reapply to see the effects. And that concludes this movie on 3D cutouts.